हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर इंग्लिश क्लास विद अ ब्यूटिफुल कोट दैट इज एजुकेशन इज व्हाट रिमेन्स आफ्टर वन हैज़ फॉरगॉटन व्हाट वन हैज़ लर्न्ड इन स्कूल. एजुकेशन इज व्हाट रिमेन्स आफ्टर वन हैज़ फॉरगॉटन व्हाट वन हैज़ लर्न्ड इन स्कूल. सो कीपिंग दिस इन माइंड वी विल स्टार्ट अवर टुडेज इंग्लिश लेक्चर. सो वी विल गो थ्रू द पोएम विच वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द लास्ट पीरियड. Come on, open your textbooks and start reciting the poem with me. Come on, start. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again, the sky bows its head in respect, for children are going to school. The sun, after his morning dip in the river, dressed up in his golden muslin turban, waits and smiles on one side of the road, for children are going to school. Through the green top branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush green foliage waves his hands, for children are going to school. Angels of light have set out. Every road is a gleam. At this hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Time, sitting on an old roof, flies pigeons in the sky, for children are going to school. Okay, children. So, I hope you started learning this poem. Okay, come on, start learning. Now, we will move towards the exercise given on page number 11. Question number 1 is, read the poem aloud. Question number 2 and 3. Children, these two answers I will be giving in PDF form. Okay, so we will discuss there. Now, come to question number 4. What is question number 4? Draw a picture of the scene described in the poem. A very interesting activity which you will love to do, that is drawing. So you have to draw the picture of the scene described in the poem. Children, draw a beautiful picture, show your creativity. You can use your classwork copy to draw the picture. Okay, children. Now question number 5. What is given? The whole world is happy because children are going to school. Why is it so? Discuss it in the classroom. Children, this 5, 6, 7, 8, these questions are open-ended question. This we will discuss and you have to write on your own. Okay. Question number 5, we are discussing that the whole world is happy because children are going to school. Why is it so? Children are going to school is a beautiful sight, is a beautiful scene. The fun they have, the little games they play, the mischievous things they do when they come to school, all make it a pretty picture. Isn't it, children? So the whole world is happy to witness this sight. Children are doing all these things. So the whole world, everyone is happy to see this sight. Apart from this, it is important that children go to school for their development and the development of the world at large. If the children are developed, the country will develop. Isn't it, children? So the whole world is happy because children are going to school. So children, in this way, you have to write this answer. You can add your own points and write the answer. Okay. Now we will move to next question. Number 6. Write about how your family supports you to go to school. You have to write how your family is supporting you when you are going to school. So children, you can write like, my family is my greatest support system. Isn't it right, children? Family is the greatest support system. They support me in every way to go to school. My mother helps me. My mother makes lunch for me, lunch box for me, and she helps me in putting my bag with books, and learning material is done by my mother. She helps me in doing my homework. My father helps me to keep my books complete. You can also write about your grandparents, how they help you, okay? Or about your brothers or sisters, how they are helping you. All these things about your family members, how they are helping you. That all things you can mention here. Okay, children? That's why this. So you have to complete this answer in this way. Then you have to add your own points that how your family is helping or supporting you when you are going to school. Okay? Now we will move to question number 5. Question number 6 is over, na? Okay, question number 6 we will start. Write about how your family supports you go to school. Okay, this question is over. We'll move to next one. Number 7. What would happen if children didn't go to school? Imagine children. What would happen if children didn't go to school? Discuss the question in groups of 5 to 8 and prepare a short composition on it. So you have to write if the children who are not going to school, children who are missing school, what happens to them? Like we can write, you have to write a small composition. You have to compose this passage, okay? Like school is a temple of knowledge. You all know that school is temple of knowledge. School is temple of learning. If children didn't go to school, they would not attain this knowledge. They will not get this knowledge. In a school, they learn different subjects, good qualities and various skills. Right, children? This helps them to become good individuals and great citizens. Children who don't go to school will miss all these experiences. They will also miss out all the fun other children have in school. Isn't it right, children? If you are not coming to school, you will miss all the fun which you experience in school. Like at present, you are missing your friends, your teachers, your all activities you are missing. Isn't it right? So in this way, the children who are not going to school, they will miss all these experiences. Okay, so we should ensure that every child is sent to school so that he or she receives good education. This will not only help him and realize his dreams. Okay, education is very important to fulfill your dreams, but also help to contribute towards national development. If a child is developed, ultimately the nation will develop. Right, children? So it is our responsibility to educate and empower ourselves and work towards a bright future. Okay, so in this way, you can add your own points and make a composition about what would happen if children didn't go to school. Okay, now we will come to question number 8. Write in short about your parents or guardians feel when they sent you to school. So here you have to write how your parents must be feeling when they are sending you to school. So parents experience mixed feeling when they sent us to school. Why they experience mixed feeling? First of all, they feel happy that we are going to school to acquire knowledge, skills and values, and at the same time they are missing our absence from home. Right, children? They are happy and they are also worried for you because you are going away from them and they are missing your absence in home. Sometimes if the school is far away, parents and guardians are worried till we get back. At the same time, they are aware that for our bright future, it is essential to go to school. Parents are also happy that we are doing our best in school by making the most of our experiences. Parents are happy and at the same time, they are also worried for us. Okay, in this way, you can discuss this with your parents. You can ask your parents how they feel when they are sending you to school. Okay, and you can frame your answer. In this way, you can write the answers. Okay, now we will see the last two questions, question number 9 and 10. In ninth one, you have to list 5 of your favorite Hindi or Marathi poems or songs. You can take the help of Google and search and write down. Try to translate any one of them into English. Okay, any one of them to English, you can translate them. Next is question number 10. Visit a library, find a school poem, recite it to your parents. So children, this visiting library, I think you can do when the school reopens. Okay, now here is one project is given. Try to complete it. What is given? Just go through sources of light. List all possible sources of light which enable you to see. Try to list at least 10 to 15. Okay, you may add the following to your list: different kinds of lamps in your house, kinds of lamps, okay, different sources you see in nature. Find out different sources used by man in the past. In the past, take the help of history and find out which were the sources used by man in the past. Question number, point number B is collect as many pictures as you can or draw diagrams of all the sources you have listed above. Okay, try to draw the pictures. Make a scrapbook using them. Point number C is think of different ways of classifying them. For example, electric and non-electric. Okay, classify them into two different categories: daytime sources, nighttime sources. Okay, this will be a fun activity for you. Okay, question number, point number D is what is your favorite source of light? Right, it's autobiography. Okay, you have to find out your favorite source of light, whichever is your source, and try to frame a autobiography in 10 to 15 lines. This will be your writing skill. Okay, children, so in this way, complete your exercise and try to learn the poem. Okay, children.